Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, depending on where in the world you are. Welcome. In this very short tutorial, we're going to go through on how to transfer data in via a USB cable from our legacy machinery. So in the event that you have a USB cable that's required and you need a driver, we're going to show you how to install a driver. Very simple. We're going to come down on our webpage here, and what we're going to do is get the necessary drivers. We're going to come into service and support. Within service and support, then we're going to scroll down here, okay, to OKM Download Center, as you see right here. Go ahead and click that. You're going to open up your download center, and then you're going to see different possible everything that we have that you can download on. We're going to look for the one box that says updates and drivers. Go ahead and click on updates and drivers. And when you click on that, you're going to come up again with a lot of various options here. What I'm going to do is scroll down here to USB drivers. And I'm going to click on download. So in Windows 11, you're going to see up here that it says usbdrivers.zip. And there's a little folder here. So I'm going to click on this little folder to open up my folders here so I can see what's here. And I have my usbdrivers.zip file. This is a zip file. It needs to be extracted. Two ways of extracting it. One is clicking up here on the extract all, and the other way is to right click and come down here to extract all. One way or the other, it's no best way. That works out just fine. It's going to come up with a destination here. And you have this little box here, show extracted files when complete. I like to have that clicked. So it's going to open up the correct folder. I'm going to just come down here, click extract. As I click on that, it's going to run through and it's going to open up the file here for our downloads. As I see up here, I'm in downloads and this is USB drivers. At this moment in time, I have the drivers downloaded. I'm going to turn on our machine, la machine. I'm going to give it some juice, a little bit of battery, and I'm going to click on our power pack, and then I'm going to hit the button.
No, not the button.
The button. And it's going to start up. Very nice, pretty look at this beautiful machine. The HP4500, one of our nicer machines throughout history. Absolutely fantastic. Gives you the same performance. And everything wonderful. I'm going to go ahead and move my USB cable over here. And I'm not going to plug it in quite yet. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to go into Windows. There's this little Windows click here, and I'm going to come over here and find my settings. And at this moment in time, it's going to open up settings. And at this moment in time, I want to go to my device manager. So find a setting. I can click in here and I can type in device manager. And I'm going to click on device manager. And you're going to have this box open up. In the event that you cannot find it here or you forget, you can come down to the Windows section here and you can select Device Manager. Right click on it and then click on Device Manager. And the same box will open up. At this moment in time, the unit is started. I am now going to plug in the USB cable. As I plug in the USB cable, it's going to refresh and you're going to see right in here says other devices, EXP4500, it is being listed. I'm going to click on this, right click on this and say update driver. This moment in time, I click on update driver and the option is search automatically for drivers or browse my computer for drivers. I'm going to click on browse my computers because I know I put it in the downloads files. Okay. And it is under USB drivers. We have this little box here that says include subfolders. It's already clicked in this instance. If it's not clicked, you can go ahead and check it. This way it'll look through all the different folders for the correct driver. I'm going to go ahead and click on next. And it is installing the drivers. And as you see here, Windows has successfully updated your drivers. Windows has finished installing the drivers for this device, and it shows you the driver. Go ahead and click close. Now that we have all this in here, I can turn around and close off some of my boxes here. And I will close off some of these multiple windows. There we go. So now that we've installed the driver, I'm going to start up the Visualizer 3D software. And we're going to want to import the data from our unit to the computer. There's a couple different ways. You can click on File and Import, or use the shortcut key Import. At this moment in time, under detectors with USB cables, it's a legacy. I'm going to select our unit and then hit Next. At this moment in time, it shows the unit serial number and it says, where do I want to put my scans? Okay. At this moment, there's also this little box down here. Delete all scan files from detector after transfer. I personally do not recommend you do that. The reason is, if you are 100% sure that your data transfer is going to be 100% complete, go ahead and click it. I don't recommend it. Reason being is, something can always happen where you say, oh, I need the data, I want to download it again because I made changes, and then it's deleted. Leave it on there until you are absolutely sure that you have worked your complete process here, leave the original data, and just bring this in. Again, do not click this delete all scan. I'm going to hit OK. It's going to look. The data transfer is happening. Receiving files 2, 3. And now, do you want to open the data? Yeah, of course I do. So I come in here. There's a file. I can either click on 1 and open it. I can highlight all of them and click open. There's no best way to do that. So if I want to just click with the first one to say, I'm going to start here. What did I do? It's going to open up the first file, and once it's finished, there we go. There's our data. And as you see, I can now work it. I can use it. I can analyze it. And that's how we work it.